Well, farming's not all about planting and harvesting. Sometimes it's about maintenance. Sometimes it's equipment, and sometimes it's animals. Find out next.
So when Danielle and I moved out here to the farm, one of our goals was to become self-sufficient. And what we learned was the very first priority is water, potable water, and water for irrigation. But water was a critical aspect of what we needed. So we're on a well, and obviously if power fails, you can't get water out of a well. Now this well is only 50 feet, but what we did years ago was we bought a Bison deep well manual pump. So that if the water pump or the well pump ever went out or the power went out for an extended period of time, we'd have water. Well, that was 4 years ago in 2016, and we never installed it. Well, the coronavirus came about, and we realized, you know what? This is a great time to take the time to actually install this manual pump. So that's what we're doing here today. This is the actual pump right here, this cylinder. That's the pump top. Over there, if Danielle can pan over there, that's gonna go on the well casing, and my well casing is over here to my left. So we're gonna drop this down 45 feet into the well. My static water level is about 25 feet, so it's about 10 to 20 feet below the static water level. And we'll be able to manually pump water if I do it correctly. And if not, I'll just cut that part out and I'll splice it, I'll fix it, and then I'll bring it back to you. So I won't show it again until it works, okay? Thanks. Got one more length to go, but what I have to do is I have to drill an 1/8-inch bleed hole in it because we're in a frost zone, obviously. And so what's going to happen is in the winter, after I use the pump, I'll wait about 3 minutes. That water will drain out of the pump through the weep hole back into the well, and it won't freeze. Done here, so we're gonna try this out, and if it doesn't work, then we'll just cut the film and do it again. Here we go. So it's got to run the water up the pipe first, so it's not primed at all.
Oh, the suspense.
That is really Hey, we've got water! There you go! We now have water. Just like the old days.
Woohoo! Now when the kids say they're bored, I'll just have them fetch water for dinner.
So, because we're working on that all day, we had that well head off. I had to cut wires and redo wires. I accidentally dropped a wrench in there. So what we did before we actually put that on is we poured a bleach solution down there just to kind of shock the well. We're gonna go ahead and flush a bunch of water out of there just to make sure everything is clean, because that's sealed up now. It's got an airtight seal on it, so it's gonna keep it pure in there. But by having that well head open for an hour or two can actually contaminate your well. So that's really important to be able to clean that out. But we're pretty excited about this.
Do I get to try it?
It goes up really easy. It's and then down just not really
it's
that
not hard. Dry at all.
No. Nope. Takes
so
a minute to prime it.
You can hear it. Sunday. There it is.
So it takes a minute to prime it.
Grace is a mare that we've been rehabilitating for a while. When we got her, her feet were a complete disaster. She was a severe founder and probably the most severe laminitis I've ever worked with. So she's been rehabbing, but she showed up yesterday morning for her minerals and she was limping really bad. I believe she has an abscess, but since it's been so rainy and mucky lately, we've decided to temporarily confine her to a dry stall so her feet can dry out and help heal up. So today she's gonna have a little spa day. It just gives her an opportunity to be out of her stall, lets me get her cleaned up, get the muck off of her, check her over really good for any injuries I might have overlooked, and just have a little fun overall. So that's why I'm dressed up in these goofy looking duds. It's actually only about 54 degrees, so I'm gonna be using a propane water tank to keep the water warm and keep her comfortable, and hopefully I'll stay somewhat comfortable and watertight here. So let's get going. Grace was a rehab mare. For those that have followed our farm on Facebook, you've read a lot about Grace's story and the progress she's made. But for those of you just joining us, I'll try to do a quick recap here. We were actually looking for a backup horse for our normal team of work horses, and typically on a farm, a working farm that is, every animal really has to kind of earn its keep in some way in order for the farm to be sustainable. So in Grace's case, she's really the first rehab case we actually took on knowingly. So when we found her, there was just something about her. I can't explain it. We were just drawn to her, even my husband, who is always practically minded. But we decided to take the risk, and after having her looked over by a vet good, she was in bad shape. She was able to walk and move, and we were able to kind of try her out a little bit, but we knew there was going to be a long, probably year or so, rehab process to do. To give you an idea, her feet were the worst. She was actually foundered. She had severe laminitis, severe white line disease from the separation of the hoof wall, and it was truly miraculous she was even walking. Her coffin bones were just on the verge of dropping right through the sole. Her soles were so thin from the previous owner literally carving the soles off of her feet. It was a really sad situation. She was very underweight. She had open sores. She had collar sores from being driven in ill-fitting equipment. She had fungal infections in her feathers, on her legs. She was just a rough deal. So we got her here. The first thing we did was change her diet. We put her on really healthy minerals, a basic grass diet, hay, which is really good for laminitic horses. And then we just started working with her slowly. We haven't been able to do any training per se, but just gradually kind of the hurry up and wait mentality. Well, fast forward to today, we're about 4 months after coming here, and today's bath was a great opportunity to really look her over once again. We've done this a few times, but it's been probably about 2 months now with the cold weather. And what I found today is her health is really, really improving. She was going through a detox process back in the fall where her skin was just producing this really disgusting reddish oily residue. And we literally couldn't brush her hair without a bath because it was so sticky and tacky. That was not the case today. The residue just wasn't there nearly as much. So I feel like we got the rest of it off of her. That's diet related. Back in the fall, we actually trimmed off all her feathers to give the legs a chance to heal from these fungal infections, let them dry up a little bit. And so today's bath, even though her feathers are growing back very quickly, which is actually a good sign, it means good improving health, good diet to produce hair, there were no signs of these fungal infections. So they seem to be clearing up really well. Her collar sore is gone. Her skin is just really smooth. Her hair is really smoothing out. And I'm really, really excited to see what happens as this progress continues. The lameness issue, now that I've looked her over good today, I'm pretty confident it's an abscess, which honestly is no surprise. You know, when you have white line disease like she does, it's just an open environment for fungus to set up, and in the muddy conditions that we're dealing with outside, it's just a perfect scenario for that storm to happen. So it's not necessarily a bad thing. It just means she's gonna hurt for a while, kind of like having a big blister on your foot that's rubbing, in a way, I guess, to try to give you an analogy. But when she walks, it's sore, she's gonna limp, but as you can see, she's eating fine, she's moving fine, and a daily walk or two is actually gonna be good for her. As long as we go slow and let her take it at her own pace, it helps that abscess work its way out. Once it ruptures, she'll have instant relief and be good to go. We may deal with a couple more through this healing process. Again, won't be a big surprise, but it's just all part of what she's gonna have to go through because of the severe neglect that she suffered previously. But meanwhile, she's here, she's being loved, she's being spoiled, pampered, and we're just kind of using the opportunity to bond with her, learn all about her, get to know her, get to know her sweet spots, and just overall enjoy her. Right, girl?
Hey, thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more of how we do things a different way, be sure to subscribe to our channel.